Candlestick Park, a stadium that has housed numerous championship teams, plays host for this matchup between the Eagles and the 49ers. You know, when you get a matchup at running back, like the one we have here today, you can just look down on the field from the booth, and you can see that breakaway speed and power with your own eyes, and there is a difference out there.
Yeah, I think I was always heard from Bill Walsh. I read it in his book, Trust Your Eyes. So you're right. We look down the field today, and as this thing goes along, you can tell we have two stars at running back, and, man, just give them a little bit of hope, and they can make it happen.
Spinning out of trouble. Down as they head to the line. They hand it off to the running back.
Well, the play is there to be made, but the offensive player doesn't get it done. Bad job on first down.
They went with the ground game on first down, bringing up second. Alden Smith with the quarterback takedown.
Well, the defense has got to be happy about this situation. Anytime early in the game you get an offense at third long, you are looking to make a play and get things rolling on your side.
Oh, it almost picked off that time.
Jim, when you get in these situations, there's not much you can do. Third and long, not easy to pick up first downs in these type of situations.
Receivers stacked up on this play. That's a mindless error on the offense.
Blame game, offense. Still fourth down.
Donnie Jones now ready to punt. Signals right away, fair catch. It's a two tight end formation. Now first and ten. He'll go to the left. He steps out, imposing their will early on the defense with a solid effort on the ground.
Well, we talk so much, don't we, about the passing game in the NFL, but it's still about who can out-hit the other one, and right now the offense, they are winning that battle. Nice run.
Gore's in the backfield, single back set. He's going to be swallowed up behind the line.
That time I got to blame the running back. He made a bad read. His vision was terrible. He makes the wrong decision. And it costs his team yards lost.
For this play, they'll go with two tight ends. Third and three. Run it again. They go to the right side.
You're near midfield. It's fourth down. What do you do? I got the answer right here. You punt it. Play field position. Make the other offense drive the length of the field to score.
They load it up now. Bring out the jumbo formation.
Here we go.
Kaepernick's going to keep the football on the quarterback sneak.
Well, that's four plays and out for the offense, and that was bad. Bad play calling, bad play, bad execution. Go to the bench and try to rethink what you're doing.
Michael Vick will be under center. First and 10. The Eagles. Get a first down. He stacked up at that point.
Hard to play man-to-man against such a quality wide receiver. He's fast. He's big. You got to mix up the coverage. You play straight man-to-man, you're going to give up a lot of completions.
Jackson's going to get set in the slot for this snap. First and 10. Ball is snapped, and the quarterback tosses it to the outside.
When you make play calls like that, you're not going to win many football games. That was a terrible call here on first down.
Second down following the run. Down and 13. Slashing to the right side. LeSean McCoy is in the backfield. Now it's a third and 13. Pass complete. Brought down. That's going to bring up fourth down.
Defensive coordinators love this situation, don't they? Third and long. They can do just about anything, and it's going to work. And they stop the offense at time.
Running back in motion here. Vic's going to take it from the gun. On the spot.
I guess that's how we're going to be today, isn't it? We're just going to go for it on fourth down. That time they go for it and they get it. Good job.
Here's the first snap after the big play. McCoy, they break through. Tackle him behind the line.
Good job by the defense. They stopped the first down play that time by the offense, and now they have a good situation.
Throws to the right. And incomplete.
The defense got away with one that time. It wasn't a good play on their part. It was just bad timing by the quarterback and receiver.
Third and goal from the 9. Challenging the defenders to the right side.
Well, when you get tackled inside the 5-yard line like that, there's so few options for the offense. Are they going to be strong enough now to push it in? We'll find out.
This is it. Short run, and it's a touchdown.
That was a nice job by the quarterback. He read the defense. He realized there was a little weakness in one spot. He goes there and gets the touchdown on the quarterback's knee.
The 49ers in kickoff return formation. Out past the 20 and brought down at the 24. They come to the line and it's first down. Frank Gore gets it here. Pushes aside one tackler.
Number 21 gets the score forward. No gain on the play.
After being stuffed at the line of scrimmage, it's now second down and 10. The throw to the left. They pick up the first down with that reception.
Well, that's a nice completion by the offense. And what it does, it just puts them in a more manageable situation so they can pick up that third down.
15 minutes down, 45 minutes to go. Back after this word from your local station. Gore's lined up as the single back. And the give to Frank Gore.
Black Rock!
Frank Gore is in the backfield.
Flip to the outside. Got a big lane.
Shakes off the hit. A foot race to the end zone. The 10, gonna take it home for the touchdown.
Good job by the offense. They get in there, they tie this game up. Now we'll see if the defense can take advantage of that momentum and keep it on their side.
Lining up now for the 2. Staying on the ground. You talk about momentum, that turns into an 8-point trip, the touchdown and the 2.
This offense and the head coach and the offensive coordinator, they're all aggressive. So, hey, well, it's not good enough just to get a touchdown. They want to get that extra point or 2 points. Nice job that time.
And he's tackled just past the 20. We'll mark it at the 22-yard line. They come to the line of scrimmage. First down. Looking to the right side and throwing. That's a gain of 8.
Good job by the receiver. Running into that defense. Through the zone. Finding the open space and making a nice catch.
So they complete that one, yet it's still second down. Got a hand on it, and it's incomplete.
Not a good job that time by the quarterback. When you see the cover 2 defense, you got to know where to throw the football. He did not, and that's why the ball goes incomplete.
This is third down. The running back goes in motion. Phipps got it in the gun. On the money. Tackle down at the 47.
That's a nice job by the offense there. Get the first down. Keep those chains moving. Give yourself 3 more opportunities.
Cooper's lined up now as a slot receiver. And he's going to pitch it here. He's got a little bit of daylight here. Now they take the football onto the opponent's side of the field.
Always good to have these types of runs. Yeah, it's not a first down, but it sends a message. It shows everybody that you can run it when you want to. And also, it opens up so many other things for your offense.
He'll be brought down, but not before picking up the first down.
Well, it's about deceiving the defense, isn't it? That's how you get a lot done in the NFL. And when you can run and pass, you can deceive them in a lot of ways. Nice job by the offense, running that football, picking up another first down and moving the chains.
Good job by the quarterback that time. He doesn't panic. He reads that it's a zone, and you have to wait for the receivers to get in between the defenders. Nice throw and catch.
Cooper's a receiver in the slot.
Second and 1.
Left side. This doesn't look good. We've got a player down, and he's in pain.
Well, that's going to hurt him tomorrow. There's no doubt about it. When you get hit like that, you're going to feel some of that pain tomorrow. But the good news is, I think he's going to be okay. And once he gets a little situated there, I think he'll be back in the game.
That reception gave them the first down. First down, throwing again. Macklin's there with the sure hand to pull in the rocket pass.
Another name for the fly route, the go route. It's a streak. That means they want you to be a blue streak, run as fast as you can, get by that defense, and make a big play.
Reaches out and snatches it 4 yards.
Well, when you keep chipping away with these short throws, sooner or later that defense is going to come up, and when they come up, that's when you throw it over the top.
Second and 5. Looking for an open receiver on the right. Touchdown!
Well, when your offense goes out there and scores a touchdown to put you ahead, it's got to give a big lift to the defense. They got to get excited and go out there and hold that lead.
And now they call the quick timeout. He'll get set, looking to convert on this 2-point try. Pitches it back.
So, put down a touchdown and a two-point conversion on that occasion.
Yeah, good job by the offense. They executed the play perfectly, and they got in the end zone, like you said, and got that 2 points.
And he's going to give his team great starting field position on that return. Gore is lined up now as the running back behind the quarterback. Kaepernick sells the play fake. Unstoppable. The 30, the 20, the 10. Inside, and he's home for the touchdown.
Well, that score ties the game up. Now on the defensive side, you got to come out there and take advantage of this feeling you got going now and get the football back for your offense.
49ers setting up for the kickoff. Able to move past the 20 and brought down at the 23. Cooper's in the slot. Takes the snap. We're about midway, second quarter. Spins away from the hit.
What a good job by the defensive player there. Just flushing the running back and driving him into the ground.
After running it, it's second down. Vic in shotgun formation. Looking across the middle, and it's incomplete. Just couldn't hold on to it after the hit.
That's why you like defenders who are good punishing tacklers. Make those receivers worry about coming over the middle. They'll be careful the rest of this game because of that big hit.
Third down and 8. He's looking to the right here on this throw.
If you want to stop big pass plays in the NFL, play cover 4. But what it doesn't stop is these short passes underneath.
They're back at the line after that catch for a first down. Back to the air here on first down. And intercepted. The tackle was made.
That was a terrible throw by the quarterback. When you're off target like that, you deserve to throw an interception.
Colin Kaepernick under center. First and 10. Kaepernick's turning to look downfield now after selling the play fake.
Crossing routes. That's what you want to throw when you see this type of coverage. 4 deep. Cover 4. Look for guys going across the field. Hard for the defense to cover those throws.
First down here after the completion. They feed the running back. That tackle was made at the 27-yard line. The 49ers step up to the line, employing now their jumbo package.
Nothing like seeing a complete offense. That's what we're watching here today. Yes, we know they can throw it, but what they're showing us here, they can grind out some first downs running the football too.
First down here after the run. Play action fake. Getting away from the pressure. And that pass is going out of bounds. Incomplete. Gore is in the backfield. Second and 10. Throws to the right. He's got the grab, and he's got the first. And that last play made by Pat Chung.
Well, you get a couple first downs on a drive. It just, of course, it makes you feel good about what you're doing. It loosens up the offensive play caller, and there's nothing like dictating to the defense. I love it.
That was a big gainer. Now it's time to back it up. And that gains one.
Good job by the defense that time. Everybody's expecting a pass. They were ready for the run, and they stopped the offense for a short gain in the red zone.
Second down coming up. Quarterback flips it to the running back. It's a touchdown.
Good job that time by the offense, scoring that touchdown and putting them ahead. And when you get ahead in a football game, the National Football League, it makes you relax and you play better.
The point after is good. The Eagles are prepared to return the kickoff. Steps out of bounds. They bring in the extra tight end, challenging the defenders to the right side. What a hit, and the ball falls incomplete. Here comes the training staff as we've got a player down on the field.
I think you can just tell by the body language and the way he's acting, that is an upper body injury. Hope it's not severe. We'll let you know as soon as we find out.
Second down, 10. Oh, almost caught. Michael Vick will be under center, looking to the right side and throwing. There's the tackle, but still, it's enough for the first down.
How do you stop these receivers now? It's almost impossible with the rules of the game. Tight coverage. That time they have double coverage on him. It doesn't matter. The throw comes. They go up. They make the catch. All you can do is raise your arm and go, well, we did our best. When you're a quarterback throwing against zone defenses, look for the open space. That's what. Did that time. He found it, and the receiver ran in there and made the catch.
This play set up by the long gainer. Vick's going back to the air on this play. Advances it out to about the 9. The Eagles have to call one right here, and they do, and they are out of timeouts. Let's see what they do on first down following that huge play. Running a little college-like option. Over the line. Touchdown.
I'd say this run by the offense is just, it's arrogance. They just say, you can't stop us. And they lined up and just shoved it down the defense's throat. Nice run there on first and goal for the touchdown.
And so they convert it here on the two-point try. Eagles getting set for the kickoff. Fair catch signal made. Colin Kaepernick under center. First and 10. Play fake here. Looks to his left. And that ball's nearly picked off, but he dropped it. Ready for intermission. First, one more play. They'll run it. Here's the handoff. Gains maybe 5. That wraps up the first half here in the city by the bay. And we'll be back to San Francisco after the break for the start of the third quarter. We're back here now in this one where the Eagles lead by 1. Gets out past the 20 and brought down at the 24. Gore is lined up behind his quarterback as the single back. First and 10, Gore. He's got room.
Well, when your team is behind, what do you do? Just come out there and get a first down. That's a nice job by the offense.
Colin Kaepernick under center. First and 10. Staying with the running game on first down. And they get to him at the 45.
You know, when the linebackers, when they see that the offensive formation has shifted to one side, well, as a linebacker, you've got to play to that strong side and try to get up there and stop the run.
They're able to move the chains after that last run. Leaning on that running attack again here on first down. It's got some daylight.
Well, when you get a couple first downs, it just gives you such great confidence. It makes everybody relax. And I always say this, when you're a relaxed athlete, that's when you play your best.
That long gain sets them up here on this play. On first down, it's back to the ground game. Nowhere else to go, and he's out of bounds.
Anytime your team is down, you're inside the other team's red zone, you look for one of your star players, your quarterback, wide receiver, or running back. They need to make a big play here.
Second and three after that last carry. The give. They knocked him down behind the line of scrimmage.
Terrible call that time by the coach. The defense was expecting run. They were up there. They were aggressive, crowd the line of scrimmage. And you just played right into their hands, and they got the tackle for the loss.
Third and five. Easy catch there. No one near him.
Nice throw that time by the quarterback in the red zone. Gets a completion. And there's some tight spots, not a lot of room, so you got to really drive the football in there.
The offense is set at the line for the first down after that completion. Tosses it to the running back. They jam it in on the goal line. Touchdown.
You got to give the offensive line just a lot of credit. It's first and goal. They just line up and power the football in there. Nice run, but a great job by the O-line.
They're going to bypass the point after and try to pick up the two-point conversion. He gets the toss, got the touchdown, got the two-point conversion. People love to go for two in this game, don't they?
Well, they do, and you know what? Now I guess you and I just can't sit here and blast the coach for a bad decision. When you pick up the 2 points, you can't complain about what they're trying to do.
And the tackle is made right around the 26-yard line. Formation here for the defense. First and 10. LeSean McCoy takes the handoff. He's brought down at the 30-yard line.
Nice run that time. When you run the football like this over a period of time, it's going to wear that defense out. There's no doubt about it. Nice job by the offensive line.
They run right. They're running the option. Here's the pitch. Shrugs off the first hit.
Good job that time by the running back. I'm sure he's a little winded after that play. He showed that speed getting out there and picking up those extra yards.
Michael Vick will be under center. First and 10. Looking for an open receiver on the right. Unable to bring it in.
It's really simple. Keep your eyes on the football. When they're not on it, that's when you drop it, and that's what happened that time.
It's now second down. Jeremy Maclin makes the grab.
You know, when you throw the football like that down the field, you pick up a first down, now you can do anything you want on the offensive side, and you got that defense guessing.
It's the old counter play.
Good job by the safety, diagnosing the run, getting up outside, and making the tackle for a short gain.
LeSean McCoy is in the backfield, second and 10, and he's going to be brought down.
Well, if your offensive line's not good enough just to stop the pass rush, then you got to help him out. How do you do that? Well, you keep the tight end in, let him be an extra blocker, and you tell your running backs to help out, too, blocking some of these defensive linemen.
He's looking to the right here on this throw. in the books. Touchdown.
Well, here we are. It's a tie game now. We'll see how the teams react to it. Will it be positive or negative?
Well, this works out about 40% of the time if you look back on history, and they'll go for that two-point conversion. Running it like it's an option play. Put an additional 2 points on the board as they convert. The kicking team now getting set here for what looks like an onside kick. The receiving team has the recovery. He's going to be tackled right around the 46-yard line. Offense lines up here. First down and 10. They give it to the back, and he's running off tackle. Pat Chung makes the tackle.
Well, that was a nice run that time off tackle. And listen, this is a bread and butter play in the NFL. It's about power running. Can your offensive tackle make the block to free up that running back so he has a chance to get that secondary and make a nice run out of it? Outside runs take time. And when you run outside, you expect the safety to get up there with that extra time and make the tackle. Good job that time by the safety.
Gore's lined up directly behind the quarterback here. They'll run with it again, and that's a gain of 9.
The NFL is about situations. A good job by the runner knowing where the first down was, gets it there, and he moves those chains.
That wraps up the third quarter here in one of the world's greatest cities, San Francisco. We'll be back in just a moment for the start of the fourth. New set of downs now after picking up the first on the ground. Trying to find an opening to the right. Brought down just 2 yards shy of the first down marker.
The off-tackle run, it's just what it says it is. You're going to read the tackle's block and decide whether you're going to go inside or outside. Usually, this is the first running play every team puts in their offense when they go to training camp. Kind of refreshing to watch, isn't it, to see a team that has faith, the toughness, and the patience to just keep running the football, grinding out these first downs, resting their defense, and tiring out the opponent's defense.
First and 10. Left side runs out of bounds.
Closer defense gets to the end zone. Their backs are against it. The tougher they get. But that time, the offense still able to pick up a few yards on an inside run.
Second down coming up. Another handoff. And Patrick Chung is able to bring him down.
Safeties now in the NFL have to cover like a corner, and they got to tackle like a linebacker. And that time the safety came up, and he tackled like a linebacker and stopped that outside run.
The offense heads to the line for the seventh play of the drive. Secures it with two hands.
Good play call that time by the offensive coordinator. Down inside, when you're inside the 20-yard line or the red zone, find ways to complete the pass. They did that time.
They've got a first down now after that catch. Staying with the passing game on first down. Ball's going to be incomplete. The hit knocked the ball out.
That's interesting. As you watch the receiver trying to make that catch, he knew the defender was close, so he didn't put all of his heart into it. The defender made a nice hit and knocks the football out to the ground.
Frank Ball's out. A recovery by the defense.
Well, that's what you call a takeaway. That time the defense just hit the ball carrier so hard that he had to give the football up, and they lose it.
Lined up in the pistol formation. First and 10. Will go ground. Quarterback coming to the line, hoping to avoid being sacked for a third time. Gain of 16.
That's what you want to do. Just get a first down, especially when you're on top. Keep the clock moving. Keep the defense guessing. Make them react instead of attack.
Setting up in the pistol on this play. First and 10. KC's hand at the football. Timeout called by the defensive unit. Leading and with possession of the football, a good place to be at this point in the game. Second down and 10. Hauls it in for the first down.
There has been good pass protection for the quarterback all day long.